गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रेन, हाउ आर यू ऑल? आई होप ऑल ऑफ यू आर वेल, फाइन, सेफ इनसाइड योर होम्स. टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद फोर्थ चैप्टर इन हिस्ट्री, दैट इज ट्राइबल्स, डीकूज एंड द विजन ऑफ अ गोल्डन एज. सो दिस चैप्टर इज कम्प्लीटली अबाउट ट्राइबल्स, दैट इज द ट्राइब्स विच पीपल यूज टू हैव इन द अर्लियर टाइम्स एंड ऑल अबाउट इट. सो नाउ वी विल हैव अ क्विक इंट्रोडक्शन. सो द ट्राइब्स हैड कस्टम्स एंड रिचुअल्स दैट वर वेरी डिफरेंट फ्रॉम दोज हु लेड डाउन बाय द ब्राह्मिन्स. So they also did not have social distinctions. So the tribes which were existing earlier during those times, they had customs and rituals, and they were very different compared to those which were given by the Brahmas. So there were completely different customs and rituals. So how did the tribal groups live? So by the 19th century, tribal people in different parts of India were involved in a variety of activities, such as subsistence farming, herding, and collection of forest products. So there were different activities through which they had their earnings, and the survival was possible on that basis. So how did the tribal groups live? Jhum cultivation, with the help of this JHUM, that is jhum cultivation. So that type of cultivation usually was found in the forest and the hilly areas. So some were hunters and some were gatherers. They hunted deer, pig, etc., and they gathered for their survival. So how they were living, that is how they were surviving, some were hunting while some were gathering. So some were hunting, and for that they had hunted a deer. So then various things were made out of that animal's skin, and then they used to sell it, and with this means they used to earn their livelihood. They used to have it for their survival. So some were herders. Many tribals lived by herding and grazing animals. They were nomads. So all of you must be knowing what are nomads. That is the people who move from one place to another, that is with their cattle and grazing animals. So this is what we call nomads. So with the help of this jhum cultivation and different activities, the tribal groups used to live. Then what was the problem of British with the shifting cultivation? Now what problem did British have during that time? So they wanted shifting cultivators to settle down and become peasants. Peasants as in the farmers. So they wanted them to settle down at one place and become farmers. So as people engaged in shifting cultivation move, a lot of calculating tax was very hard. So settled cultivation in those areas where water was scarce. So jhum cultivators, they were also forced to take up a settled cultivation because their fields hardly gave good yield. So this was the problem that Britishers had faced, that is their tax calculation was becoming hard, and so they asked them to stay at one place so the tax calculation becomes easy. So this was the problem that British had. You can see the picture of shifting cultivation. We have already studied earlier also in the geography part shifting cultivation, so you might be knowing well. Now how did the colonial rule affect the tribal lives? So how did that rule had actually affected the tribal lives? So during pre-colonial time, that is during those earlier times, tribal chiefs enjoyed many administrative and influencing rights. So they enjoyed having that influential rights, but during the colonial period there was a loss of power for the tribal chiefs. They had to obey the British law. So the tribal chiefs, they cannot have their own rules and regulations, but they had to obey the British law, and the government restricted the rights of the tribal chiefs. So the tribal chiefs, they were also being restricted by the government, and so they had to completely follow, that is they had to completely obey the British law. So that was this was how they had survived. And then what actually happened to the shifting cultivators is what we study now. They wanted the tribals to settle down. British government wanted tax, therefore they wanted tribals to settle down, as it is easier to calculate the tax. So the settled cultivation was not successful where water is scarce and soil is dry. So in those places where water is scarce, that is scarcity is there, water is not available, and where the soil is dry, settled cultivation was not at all successful over there. Facing widespread protests, the British had to ultimately allow them the right to carry with the shifting cultivation in some part of the forest. So then British had to anyhow allow the cultivators, that is the jhum cultivators, to continue with their activities as they were doing it earlier. So this is what we have studied today, that how tribal groups used to live, how they used to do things for their own survival. So I hope you are clear with this part of the chapter. Thank you and have a nice day.